Hello and welcome to OCUK TV. Today we're going to be looking at the brand new NVIDIA GTX 760 graphics card. This is NVIDIA's new mid-range graphics card to replace the old GTX 660. This is a mid-range card which we predict to be extremely popular with gamers. It comes as standard with a 2GB of VRAM, which is extremely useful for playing intensive games such as Far Cry 3 and Crysis 3 at 1080p resolutions. Let's get down to the nitty-gritty. The NVIDIA GTX 760 features a GK104 graphics chip. This is based on a heavily revised version of the Kepler chips seen in previous NVIDIA cards. The standard GPU clock speed on a reference NVIDIA card is 980 MHz, with an overboost function of 1033 MHz. This is an extremely fast speed for a standard card, which means you can reach the speeds of over 1 GHz on any card. Overclock cards can run at even higher speeds, such as this MSI card we have here. So will the GTX 760 fit in your system? Well, it features two PCI slots, so it's just as big as any other standard mid-size graphics card. And it also takes two 6-pin PCI power connectors. So any power supply from 400 to 600 watts will easily power it. Anything more is totally overkill. Unless, of course, you're wanting to use them in SLI. Our friends at Vortez have put the GTX 760 up against several other cards. We put the GTX 760 against a few rival cards that were just a little bit more expensive. Now we're going to take a look at a couple of the results. A Uni Engine Heaven 4 with a 1920 by 1080 with 0x AA, the GTX 760 scored 12.52. Which wasn't far off the more expensive cards. In SLI, it scored a massive 2422, just shy of the mighty GTX Titan. We ran the benchmark once again, but this time with 8x AA. The GTX 760 then scored 443, again, not far away from its rivals. And in SLI, it reached 843, outperforming the mighty Titan. We also played Battlefield 3 at a 1920 by 1080 resolution in high settings with no AA. The GTX 760 reached 95.5 FPS, very close to its rivals once more, and actually just pipping the GTX 680. In SLI, it hit a massive 155.31 FPS, again beating the Titan. In ultra settings with 4x AA, the GTX 760 scored 67.31 FPS, and in SLI it got 125 FPS, and you guessed it, it beat the Titan again. Vortez then upped the ante, putting Battlefield 3 at the huge 2560 by 1600 resolution on high settings with zero anti-aliasing. The GTX 760 managed to get 54 frames per second, which is still a very respectable FPS for such a mid-end card. In SLI, however, it got 103 frames per second, which is absolutely perfect. We pushed the card even more, and we upped the settings to ultra and applied 4x anti-aliasing, where it got 39.55 FPS. And in SLI, it reached 73.33 FPS. The results are surprising, and eTechnics even awarded the KFA2 GeForce GTX 70 the almighty Best Bang for Buck Award. So how much performance will the GTX 760 get you? Well, we tested one in one of our mid-range gaming computers and tested it with Far Cry 3 and Crysis 3 at a 1080p resolution. On Far Cry 3 at ultra settings, it was getting a huge 50 FPS out the box at its standard clock speed. On Crysis 3, we saw this dip slightly to 46 FPS. The GTX 760 on average achieves 7 FPS higher than the previous GTX 670, which of course was a higher end card upon release. Once overclocking the card, you can reach speeds up to 1090 MHz. You can do this without any kind of overvoltage. We use MSI's afterburner technology to do this, which is very, very simple and easy to do with adjustable sliders. Once the card was overclocked, we saw gains of over 11 FPS in both titles. So it's an ultra overclockable card and very easy to use. So let's talk about the card we've got in front of us. This is the MSI GTX 760 2GB Twin Frozer OC Edition card. Now, looking at this card straight away, you can see it doesn't have a reference cooler. It has MSI's own Twin Frozer 2 design. Now, this design not only keeps the card cooler, it looks pretty good and allows for a very high overclock. In fact, the clock speed of this car is 1085 MHz, which is actually higher than the standard overboost on a reference card. The overboost in this card gets to over 1100 MHz, which gives you fantastic games, as we've already seen playing the latest DX11 games. Now onto power consumption. This card, rather than the standard 2 6-pin PCI connectors, has a 6-pin and an 8-pin, so you might need a little bit more juice to run this card than a standard reference design. For the outputs, you have 2 dual-link DVI connectors, a full-size DisplayPort, and HDMI, so you've got access to all of your outputs for whatever you need the card for. In addition to this fantastic MSI card, we stock cards from brands such as Asus, Gigabyte, and KFA2, and they're all on stock on our website now. For more information, check out the links below. Goodbye for now.